Hello again. So, a lot of my videos I've been doing, I've noticed a lot of people don't even have a very basic understanding of AutoHotKeys. I've done some, you know, videos on GUIs, INI files, but I've come to realize some people don't even know how to even create their first script. So I decided to kind of rewind a little bit here and show you some very basic functionality. Hopefully it helps some of the very new people using this for the first time, or just a refresher course from some of you guys. So the first thing to install AutoHotKeys, if you don't already have it on your computer, you can just jump over to their website. You can just go to Google and type in AHK. That's going to be the first result. And right on their main page, they're actually going to have the download button. Clickety-clack. Sorry if you guys can hear my mouse clicks on this mic. It's not the greatest. I recommend just downloading the most current version for sure. When you push this, I already have it installed, so I'm not going to show that portion, but you'll get a zip file. Just unzip that, run the installer. It should be really quick. Doesn't install any, you know, ad software or, you know, some of those like random games that some softwares like to sneak in there. It's just pure HK, which is really, really nice. So once it's installed, you're ready to make your first script. So one thing I do want to point out is there's two ways really to run a script. So if you have AutoHotKeys installed on your computer, your AutoHotKey file or script, you can actually just run it just like this. I work at a big company. Not everybody has AHK installed on their computers, so I have to compile it into an executable file. When you install AutoHotKeys, it's going to come with that compiler, and it looks like this. So it's pretty straightforward. You know, your source, it's going to be your code. Use that example. Browse. This is just what you want to name it. You can change the icon for the executable to whatever you want. It does have to be a ICO file. You can pretty much take any picture you want, and there's tons of websites out there where you can convert them into an ICI file or an icon file. I'm just going to leave it at the default, though. So I'm going to go ahead and push convert. Down here, it tells you what it's doing. It's usually pretty fast. Conversion complete. And there's my executable. So you can definitely tell the difference. You know, this one's very green, big old H on it. But this can be launched from anybody's computer, regardless if they have AutoHotKey downloaded on their computer. So this is helpful if you're going to be sharing this with other people or working at a large company like I do. But we don't need that, so I'm going to delete that. Alright, on to our first script. So, if you're new to programming, Hello World's pretty much the first thing you ever learn in pretty much every language. So that's what we're going to stick with. So what is a hotkey? Well, up here, in this line, I have a hotkey. A hotkey is basically when you push a button on your keyboard. You can also use your mouse, wheel up, wheel down. There's a lot of options, but I usually just stick with the function keys. I don't really ever use them, so they're kind of a waste of buttons for me. I'd rather have them do something else. So I'm just going to use the F1 key here, as you see. And then you just put these dot dots right here. So if there's two there, that's saying, when I press this, do the stuff below it. So my script's a little bit spread out here. You don't have to do that. It's just a little bit easier to view on a video, I think. If you don't agree, let me know. Why not? So the first thing is a variable. And a variable is just a way to store data. So right here, I'm just having Tom's variable. This can be named whatever you want. It can just be called variable if you want. Don't recommend doing that, but to each his own. Equals, and then what do I want to be the string in that variable? So it's just going to be hello world. So when this script runs, I push F1, this variable is going to be created into the memory. Something to remember, when you do close out your script, all the variables get cleaned out and don't exist anymore. I did a video a few days ago called INI2 variable saving. You can have all these variables if you really need saved to a file on your computer so they can be recalled later, versus having to have them always, you know, either be hard-coded or retyped. So next thing I want to do, I want to display Hello World, so I'm just going to use a simple message box. That's Msgbox, comma, and then my variable. So if I'm calling upon a variable, I'm going to put it in percent signs, one at the beginning, one at the end, and that's saying this should be a variable. If I don't include those, and I just did a message box this way, it would actually display the word Tom's variable. But I don't want to do that. I want it to say hello world. Last thing we got there is a return. A return is basically a stop sign. So when it reaches that line of code, it's saying you're done. Don't do anything else. Even if there's code below that return, it's going to stop right there. So let's go ahead and run that one. So I got it running. I'm going to push F1. There we go. Message boxes, pretty simple. They just display whatever text you have and an OK button, and also a close button if you want. When you have a message box open, your script is actually going to stop right there at line 5 until I close this, and then it's going to move on. There's nothing under that but a return, so it just stops there. So there's your first hello world. Welcome to the world of programming. Let's get a little bit more fancy, shall we? So, once again, I got my hotkey up here. I'm just using F1 again. This time, I just named it variable T, hello world. Got my message box down here exactly like in the last one. But in this one, I'm going to use an if statement. An if statement's basically looking for something to be true. So in this one, I just have variable, if variable t equals hello world, do what's inside this bracket, which is just a message box. So always make sure after your if, you put this little bracket here, and make sure you always close what you want to happen if this equals true inside the brackets. And that's all it's going to do. So let's go ahead and show you that. It's just going to look exactly like the last one did. Hello world. Pretty simple. But as you see, I also have an else. So this message box never displayed. That's because this equaled true up here. If this didn't equal true, for example, let's say I delete the word or the letter O. Well, variable T will no longer equal hello world. So it's going to go to the else and say, okay, well, if this doesn't work, then I should do this instead. And that's just a message box, did not equal true. So I want to run that, and I should get that second message box instead. So F1. I think I'm running multiple scripts there. There we go. Did not equal true. Also, make sure you're not running multiple scripts that use the same hotkey, because they can step on each other and cause some issues. Normally, when you launch a new script, if you have a duplicate hotkey, the most currently launched one will be the one it actually triggers. But that doesn't always seem to work properly, like you just saw there. Most of the time, 90% of the time, it does what it's supposed to do, but not always. And then I just put a return at the end. I put the return outside of the brackets just because I just want it there. Why not? If I really wanted to, I could put a return here and here. But that's two lines of code versus just one. So let's say we want to get multiple hotkeys. So in here, switched it up a little bit. Why not? Apparently that makes life interesting for me. F2. And I'm going to use F3. I'm also going to not use a message box this time. I'm going to use a send. So a send is basically just mimicking what you do on a keyboard when you type. So this is saying send hello world. So it's literally just going to type out hello world. And then it's going to hit that return and stop. If I forget to put this return here, it'll actually continue on here and it would actually send again. I don't want it to do that. I want it to stop right there. I only want this to trigger when I actually push F3. So F3 is a little bit different. It's doing a send, but it's doing a variable. It's calling from up here. So once again, just make sure you put it in parentheses, because without those, it would actually send the word hello variable. Don't want to do that. I want it to actually send hello world. So let's try that out. I'm going to open up a notepad, so we can just do that in here. Make sure I close out of my last one. So I'm going to go ahead, push F2. There we go. Hello world. Let's go down a little bit. Push F3. Hello world. So that just types out like you would do. Another thing too, as you saw, it kind of did it letter by letter. If you want it to be a little bit faster, you can actually do something like this. You could do clipboard equals hello world. And then here I'm just going to put the, instead of a variable, I'm actually going to do a control, which is just the up caret, V for paste. So I'm just doing a control V or a paste. This is actually a lot faster. It's pretty much instant. So let's try that out. So I'm going to go ahead and push F2. Oops, F2, not 2. And you see how much faster that was? It's milliseconds that it's faster, but if you're pasting like a huge template to something that's like a paragraph long, you're definitely going to want to go with that control V instead with a variable assigned to your clipboard. It's going to be way faster than the computer typing out an entire paragraph. Still faster than you could type it out, but hey, let's try to go as fast as possible. So send V, definitely the way to go. Another thing you can do is you can also, instead of a send, if you want to mimic a left click, you can just literally say click. There's a few different ways to do this. You know, there's mouse click, send click. But if you're just looking for a simple left click on your mouse, just put click. And that will work perfectly fine. So last thing I wanted to touch base on, I'm not really going to show it, just more or less explain it. I made a few videos about GUIs. GUIs are basically just, they're kind of like message boxes, but way more fancier. Message boxes are only going to display text in your system's format. Where with a GUI, you can add your own buttons, drop downs, you can change the font, size, color, style. There's a whole bunch of stuff you can do. So it's just like a much fancier way to do it. I'll link that first GUI video in there if you want to check those out. The cool thing about GUIs is they can also work almost like hotkeys. So when I push a button, it's going to run whatever script the handler's assigned to it. But I explained that a lot more over there. So definitely check that out. I think at the time of this filming, I have 4 GUI videos, if I remember correctly. So they're pretty cool to check out. One last thing I wanted to point out is if you ever write a script that you don't want to use hotkeys in, you just want it to... Basically, as soon as you double-click on it, you want it to just run. You can do that. The only thing is once the program runs, it's going to automatically close out. If you do want it to stay up here, you can just add a hashtag persist, and that will keep it open. So like in all my videos, I will post the code down below in the description. If you guys want to see more on, you know, very basic stuff, intro kind of stuff, let me know what exactly you're looking for. I'll definitely be doing a few more videos, so I kind of want to see where you guys want me, my direction that you guys want me to go into. Subscribe. I'm uploading 2 to 3 of these, sometimes even more a week, in all different kind of categories. INI files, GUIs, now I'm doing intro stuff. How to use it to automate Chrome or Internet Explorer. AutoHotKey is super powerful, really easy to learn.